Hey guys, Sal here, and welcome back to some more Fairy Fencer F Advent Dark Force. Let's get started. I honestly have no clue what the hell I was doing last. You can talk about memories till you're blue in the face. Nothing's ringing any bells. Oh, don't worry about it. All you gotta do is keep pumping out those delicious meals of yours. I see. So this is how you treated me before, is it? Pretty much. Could you pet my head? Ah, my darling Ethel wants some affection from me. Okay, how's this? Not quite right. Never mind. What? What's wrong with my pet? Baldo, he wasn't a bad person, was he?
I don't think so, even if he did become a Dwarfus stooge in the world. What a doofus.
Do you think it would be okay if I offered him some flowers once in a while?
I think that's a great idea. He never showed it, but he always got lonely easily. I'm sure that'd make him happy.
I'm sure too.
Just think, we're on the edge of the Vile God's revival. I feel as if my eyes have gone senile.
Yeah, I'd say they have. You ended up doing Dwarfa's dirty work and everything.
As their former figurehead president, you wouldn't do well to keep your thoughts to yourself.
I owe you a sincere apology. Everything we heard about the Vile God was completely true.
Please, don't beat yourself up over it. Any mistakes you feel you've made can be redeemed through your future actions.
I cannot allow Pippin to slice his belly open to atone for our actions, so may I offer myself on his behalf.
I'm afraid after a few years I will not assist you in the act, so you would not certainly suffer for hours.
Not certainly. Okay, I need to read more.
It's been a while since we've talked. Would you say you've, changed?
I do not understand your question. Neither my interior nor exterior components have changed in the slightest.
Well, you've got Huey on your head.
Huey!
I did not place Huey there. My head has been occupied without authorization. However, there is no need to take action at this time.
So you really have changed!
I'd say so.
Yo, so you're part of the team too now, huh? I look forward to working with you.
Who gave you permission to speak to me so casually?
Jeez, calm down. Guess you're not too friendly yet, huh?
He seems perfectly friendly with Lord Sherman and me.
What? So it's just me? That's discrimination.
I understand that you used to be the president of Dwarfa.
To think such a fool could rise to the top. I was right to leave when I did.
What did you just say?
Whoa, hey, calm down. We just became friends, so try to get along, would you?
Fine. As the mature adult in this situation, I'll let it go.
Well, anyway, this turned out okay. I'm sure Emily will be able to relax knowing you're with us.
What? How do you know my sister?
Oh crap, that's right, I haven't met her yet.
Never mind, you don't have anything to be suspicious about,
What's this about Apollonius' sister?
Oh yeah, I guess I never told you either. Come here, I'll explain. You remember how I killed Apollonius in the other world, right?
Yeah.
Well, later I ran into his little sister. Her name's Emily, she said she was on a journey to find her brother's killer.
Oh jeez, so she must have really hated your guts, huh?
Keep your voice down, idiot. You're gonna give him the wrong idea.
Oops, sorry.
Besides, it wasn't just me. Her hatred would have extended to the entire group, and...
Would you care to fill me in on the details of your story?
You don't have to draw your sword. Just calm down and listen.
No, there is no need for further explanation. I shall claim that foolish head of yours.
Your boiling point's way too low, man. Come on, Aaron, say something.
I need to go now. Good luck.
You're abandoning me?
You shall pay for besmirching my sister with your life.
I didn't besmirch anything, just listen.
Alright.
Greetings, or shut up. Perhaps I should say a long time no see.
I guess so, but that doesn't feel quite right to me.
That's so. I hope you realize that we've had quite a bit of trouble.
Sorry about that. Things were kinda out of my control, you know, so, don't worry about it.
Indeed. It doesn't actually bother me at all, except...
Except?
Aaron and I went through a lot, getting dropped in an unknown world. We understood our predicament, but nobody else kept their memories. Our one ray of hope was Aaron's partner. But when we found him, not only were his memories gone, but he was serving as our enemy's president.
Yeah, you're not wrong, but...
He must have been living quite a nice life. So much so, you didn't give your partner a second thought. What an enviable position.
This is actually what really bothering you, isn't it? Like, a lot.
Oh no, not in the slightest.
Liar! You keep on complaining, you're laying the sarcasm on super thick.
Perhaps you only hear it that way because you have guilt living within your heart.
Seriously, I really do feel bad about it, okay? I mean it.
Then please give me a truth to your words through your actions from this point forward.
I don't need you to tell me that.
Once we've resolved the situation, I will air the rest of my complaints.
So you were complaining!
Of course he was.
Hey, do you have a second?
What's up, Mr. President?
Please don't call me that. I'm not the president anymore.
Funnily enough, I'm not an employee anymore.
Then you really shouldn't call me that.
I can't help it. I just love the face you make when I call you that.
That's like ancient history. I just want to forget that I was ever dwarf as president.
Dang, that just makes me want to call you that even more.
Seriously, give me a break. I'm begging you, okay?
Fine, if you insist. So what should I call you then, Mr. Ex-President? Or maybe I should refer to your current job, Mr. Homeless Sir Hobo Master Jobless, good for nothing. Which do you prefer?
Can't you just use my name?
Name it is. I look forward to working with you, Fang.
Great. Is it just me, or has your personality changed for the worse?
I have no idea what you might be comparing it to. I've always been like this.
Oh, I guess that's true. Man, this is annoying.
Okay, so...
Huh? So what?
So you're here because you wanted something, I assume?
Huh? What was it? I totally forgot.
I admire how scatterbrained you are. I'm genuinely impressed you could become a company president.
I told you to stop saying that. I just lost track because you started before being all weird.
Oh, sorry, I guess.
Damn it, I'll be back once I remember why I came here.
Right, I'll be waiting. He's as nuts as usual. It looks like, but at least he doesn't seem so abrasive now that he's not president. Probably dumb of me to think he was actually worried about me. Hey there, so have you calmed down?
What are you talking about? I'm always calm. I'm Fang the Calm and Cool.
You don't have to act tough, you just got all your memories back, so I'm sure you must be pretty confused.
I'm not some little kid. Just because my memories may have gotten a little jumbled doesn't mean I'm...
Confused? You are, aren't you?
Maybe just an eensy-weensy tiny little bit.
Okay, so what
does it feel like having different conflicting memories?
That's a tough question to answer.
I see. I shouldn't be surprised your brain can't come up with an answer to that question. Sorry.
Hey, come on! Don't be so quick to give up. Let me think.
I do have different memories, but the old ones are real, right? So they feel more like reality.
The time you spend with me feels more real, you mean?
Yeah, that's the feeling I get.
Heh. That's good then.
I wouldn't say it's good. That means all the memories I made in this world are fake.
It's actually super depressing.
Oh, right. All those steaks, all those top-notch seafood bowls I had as president, it's like they never really happened.
Huh? Could you go into a little more detail on that?
What, like about the steak? The best was this giant one that was lightly seared on the outside. It was like meat sashimi.
That sounds amazing! What about the seafood bowls?
You know the shrimp that usually comes with your standard seafood bowl?
Sure, those cute little ones, right?
Well, instead of those, mine came covered in whole lobsters.
What? Covered it like the whole entire bowl?
I couldn't believe my eyes the first time I saw it. Even now, I can hardly believe it was real.
And what about the taste? How did it taste?
One of the best things I've ever tasted. Man, Aaron is totally fang sparing.
Not fair. I want to try it. I want a lobster bowl.
We could take our entire life savings and we would still wouldn't be able to afford it.
This isn't fair, Fang.
So many people, dang. Hey, so why didn't you tell us you were a fairy?
You never asked. Besides, what would be the point of telling you? And I figured it would have been way more impact.
Would have had way more impact if I announced it just as the conversation was starting to get exciting, don't you agree?
Actually, I think it might have been less impact because of how exciting the conversation was. Well, I'll just chalk that up as a failure of the presentation. Need to experience some proof for next time.
What? So now you're giving up presentations?
Seriously though, the more people that know I'm a fairy, the more headaches it causes. This world is already dangerous enough for a lovely young maiden. Yeah, I can totally relate.
Oh yeah? And what is this lovely young maiden you're talking about?
I'll slap you. I'll punch you.
Wait, why are you getting mad? Oh, but if you want to slap me with that wad of bills again, I wouldn't mind. It hurt, but it felt good in a way.
Sorry, but I deposited all that cash. You mind if I use this bag full of silver coins instead?
Couldn't that kill me?
If it did, you could just deposit the coins and there'd be no evidence. It's the perfect crime. Oh, but some of the coins might get blood on them and they'd get all over your purse. That'd be kinda gross. Still, no matter how bloody it gets, it's still worth the same amount. That's one nice thing about cash.
You guys are taking this a little too far. I'm still alive, right? Heck, you haven't even hit me yet.
A certain someone managed to derail our conversation once again. Yeah, it's all your fault. Seriously, Fang, thanks a lot.
Me? You're blaming me?
Anyway, the fact that I'm told you I'm a fairy should show you just how much I trust you. You'd better not betray that trust.
So much talking. Yo, so you joined up too, huh? I look forward to working together. Yeah. Why the hell are you attacking me? That's a real sword, you know.
You managed to dodge my attack.
I was right to cling to life.
I had no idea there were so many skilled warriors left in this world. You're not making any sense, man. So, now that you've finally regained your memories, I've come up with a perfect penitence for you. Jeez, let it go, would ya? Your attitude sucks as ever hard as it ever did. What I want is payment in full for all expenses I incurred during your search and rescue operation. I sincerely apologize for everything I've done. Please forgive me from the bottom of my soul, I beg of you. Come on, hurry up and get those materials. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Don't rush me, jeez. Weren't you our enemy like 5 minutes ago? Being able to switch gears on the fly is one of my many talents. Now get the lead let out. Why are you staring at me like that? I'm just wondering, how come you're the only one? What are you talking about? Your memories, Harley and Pippin, don't remember anything. I'm just wondering why you're the only one who remembered. Well, you and Sherman remember too, right? Sure, but neither of us lost our memories in the first place. Well then, there you go. I guess my mind just works differently from everyone else's. Or the fact that you're the fencer of the goddess, Fairy. It's true that your brain is remarkable in a bad way, but do you really think that has something to do with it? If I say no, will you cut me some slack? Oh, that's right. I'm a total idiot. That's why I remembered. I'm so sorry. It's not good you're an idiot, but it is good you remembered. I just think it'd be nice if everyone else did too. Oh, that makes sense. They might remember if you, like, whack them in the head hard enough. That's a pretty stereotypical approach. Well, I'm an idiot, right? You can't expect me to come up with anything better. But it might be worth a shot. Okay, Pang, close your eyes. Huh? Hey, hold on. What are you planning? You're the one who suggested a shot to the head. Why do you need to hit me? Go after the ones who don't remember. Oh, I couldn't do something so mean to them, but I feel like I can do it if it's you. No, you can't. I already remember everything. There's no point. But if I hit you and you forget, that would mean it works, so it'd be good to know, right? No, that's not good. Don't worry, if you do forget, I'll just hit you as hard as I can one more time. You just want to hit me. That's it, isn't it? So, and you figured it out? Well, thanks to everything that's happened, I've got a lot of stress built up. You can let it out another way. You could at least try to lie. You're a guy, right? So one little tap should be fine. Okay, here go. Being a guy has nothing to do with it. Stop, you idiot. Stop! After closer inspection, you don't seem like such a bad guy. You're totally broke, though. You didn't need to mention that last part. Besides, I used to buy all kinds of info from you before. What do you want from me? Oh, don't worry about it. I'll just have the guy with all the money buy it for me. Damn it, you've already replaced me, huh? thanks. What's up? That got your tongue? No, it's just, I just wanted to say welcome home, okay? Huh? But I haven't gone anywhere today. That's not what I mean. Forget it. I said what I wanted to say. This Fang is dull as ever, huh? Come away. Anything to say, no? You want the pub? The Lusamundo Ice Cave. Oh, you're going to the Lusamundo Ice Cave. It's a cave on Mount Lusamundo. Oh shit. The tallest mountain in the Catacus mountain range. I heard it used to be some kind of research facility. Apparently the low temperature was perfect for preserving specimens. Oh, so that's where we were going. Memories has now been fixed. Save the game after talking to basically everyone. Okay, the Lusamundo Ice Caves.
So this is where the Minimacron is hanging out?
You got it! This place just oozes that kind of mysterious atmosphere, don't you think?
Yes, I do think.
And guess so. Man, I'm hungry. Hey, Bajas, you got some cookies or something? You've always got something on ya.
Don't get too friendly, kid. Why should I give you any of my cookies?
He does.
Harsh, Bajas.
What do you expect? You're basically strangers, remember? Lord Sherman and I are the only other ones that have our memories from before.
Still, I'm glad your memories came back, Fang. I wasn't sure what we were going to do if they didn't.
Yeah, about that. Don't get used to this, but sorry about that. I'm really embarrassed thinking about how obsessed with money I was.
Indeed you were. I have to admit, I did enjoy letting you believe you were going to go crazy at your new company.
If only you could have given all that money you spent to those bandits to us instead and put it in our trust fund. We could have really used it.
What? Damn it, Sherman! There's some things you just don't joke about! You're gonna keep that promise, mark my words! You hear me? First up is sushi, as much as I can eat. Then, meat, also as much as I can eat. Next is the caviar, and foie gras, and truffles. And don't forget the dessert! You better believe that's as much as I can eat! I'm not stopping till the last cup of cappuccino! Hey, where'd everyone go? Hey, wait up! I said wait! You better keep your promise! I mean it!
Alright. Okay, so I'm finally able to play with the controller now.
Let's make this interesting.
Here I come.
Interesting to be able to play with the controller. It's also interesting since I haven't actually played this in a while.
I'll do my best.
That I'm actually doing it right now.
Get ready.
Let's see. Hello, I gotta say it's much easier playing this on a freaking controller.
Here we go.
With the pain in my ass playing this on a keyboard.
My turn.
Okay, magical axe.
It's my turn.
How much experience do we get?
Everyone, thank you.
Not that much. Okay, so that's the dash on the controller. Okay, what are you? Potions, green goggles. Alright. Oh, now we gotta go this way, I believe. That item. Okay. Come over here. That's a blocked off way. Okay, this way.
I gotta say, I'm pretty surprised. I never expected you, of all people, to join the group. What? Come on, say something. You can talk, right? I mean, all you said before was kill.
Oh god, now he's bringing it up.
Kill? Kill! How the hell do you know that? Oh, I get it. You're some kind of eavesdropping stalker, aren't you? You're gonna die, creep! That is what Ethel just said.
She does know that he's Aaron's Spencer, right?
That's a whole lot for just two words.
Well, my translations are based mostly on feeling, so...
I don't really get it, but sorry if I made you mad.
It's okay. As long as you learned your lesson.
Anyway, I like you a lot more now that you're not just saying kill, kill over and over again. Okay, let's get going. Aaron will kill us if we're late again.
What's wrong, Ethel? You're blushing. He patted my head. Oh my, are you embarrassed? That's so cute. I just want to squeeze you to death. Please.
What are you doing? Come on, you're going to get left behind.
Ethel was embarrassed that Fang patted her head. Sweet. We'll get a relationship development between the two. That is what I kind of want to happen. Okay, so that's also that. Damn it. I was dragging myself into a corner. Don't even try it. Alright. Damn it. Yeah. Save the game. Yes. Okay, one average health is already.
See? Here it is. This is definitely the Minimacron.
Oh, I guess it is. Okay, Aaron. Go ahead and grab it.
Huh? No way! Why do I have to do it?
Past experience tells me there's usually traps in places like these. I want to check and see.
What? Then you do it!
No, no, no. This is your time to shine. Besides, I'm your master, right? It's the servant's duty to do what their master says.
I am not your servant! A fencer and his fairy are equals! They're partners, heart and soul!
But I'm telling you, in a place like this...
If you feel so strongly about it, go on ahead!
Whoa! What the hell, Pippin? What you going to kick me for? Huh?
Oh, trap activated. Good job, Pippin.
That really was a trap. Arrows, boulders, a flash flood.
Don't just stand there flapping your lips! Do something and help me!
Don't get distracted or you're dead for sure! Now get to it!
Damn it! Go!
Damn it, Pippin, why'd you do that?
That was too close. But now we can finally get the Minimacron.
Oh shit.
Now what?
It looks like the Minimacron has a guardian. I don't think we could do anything until we take it down.
Hey! Now's no time for casual conversation! It's headed this way! Get over here! I don't have any weapons!
Oopsie, that's right. Okay, I guess we should get going.
Ow! It bit me! Do you hear me? It bit me! Aaron, get your ass over here! I can't do this without you!
What a pitiful boy. But I suppose we can't leave him to die. Shall we, Soji?
Yes, Pippin.
I mean, it is your fault that he's an MS.
Alright! Let's get fired up!
Here I come!
It's gonna slash.
My turn.
Some decent damage being done.
Let's do this!
Myself.
Let us begin.
New data.
Guns akimbo. Magical lance. Of course,
here
he doesn't really do anything to me because of my levels.
Let's do this. Let us begin.
I forget how long it took me to get to these levels.
Here we go.
It's been a while since I've actually been on the game.
My turn.
Let us begin.
Oh, right, now he's actually starting to do something.
New data.
Let's do this.
My turn.
Give him the heal. You can. Play yourself.
My turn.
Here I come.
My turn.
Brace yourself.
Here we go.
Get ready!
My turn.
Doing
here
so very well so far.
This. Execute.
It is taking a while to actually kill him now.
New data!
Get ready!
I need an area of effect here.
Here I come!
Okay, Shaman, yeah, health is decent. Hello.
And good whenever!
Come on, Harley, come on.
Let us begin.
Okay, that's decent enough.
New data!
My keep going!
Man, that was rough.
You're all heartless monsters! What would you have done if I died?
Oh, come on. We got the Minimacron, didn't we? And you're alive, so everything
worked
out
fine. Yeah, but you do know that if he dies, Aaron dies, and thus your way to stop the Vile God is also gone.
It's not fine. I don't appreciate how you people are treating
me. Although, again, we're going for the Vile God route, so doesn't matter.
I'm the protagonist, you know. The hero. You should treat me accordingly.
Hey, kid. That was some nice footwork out there. I'd say you've earned some cookies. No more than three, though.
Whoa, seriously? Hand them over. Now that's what I'm talking about. Man, I forgot how good your cookies are. See? This is more what I had in mind.
So you just wanted someone to give you some food.
Hey, you gotta have some more hiding in there somewhere, right?
I'll fix you a proper meal when we get back to the inn. Will that do? What a little glutton.
I'm expecting some mammoth proportions, okay? I've used up a lot of energy today.
Yeah, yeah.
All right! Let's head back so I can dig into some of Bajas's delicious cuisine!
I'm not sure if I'm happy or sad that he got his memories back.
Minimacron. Alright. What are you doing? You're gonna catch a cold. I was just tanking in the night air and doing some thinking. Thinking? Yes, I was thinking about why we have come to this world. That's a pretty deep topic to be thinking about. I do possess a proper intellectual curiosity, after all. Oh God, cannot be allowed to exist, yet we failed to eliminate it. But now we've been given a second chance. We could have won in the last world, but just, you know, ended up with us in a bit of a bind. Let's admit, even if you were the only one left, you could have managed to hold on and squeeze out a lucky win. Better take that as a compliment or an insult. A little of both, I suppose. Okay, got it. Anyway, there's no point worrying about this stuff. We just have to do what we can from this point on. Do what we can. Listen, Fang. About Tiara. Huh? What's with the sudden topic change? Actually, it's not a change at all. Tiara is a descendant of the Vile God. Yeah? The Vile God must be destroyed, which means... What if I told you I'd kill her if I had to? You wouldn't be able to. He's saying you would protect her. You talk big, but you couldn't actually go through with it. Am I wrong? I apologize for such needless discussion. Perhaps I was being a little too arrogant. You just think too much. Get some sleep and forget about it. I will try. I would appreciate it if you could also forget what we had this conversation. I'm sure it'll be forgotten by morning, and like some other people, I'm not that smart. And with that, I'm going to end this episode of this thing. So, watch out. See you guys next one. Until then, see you later.